Hello everyone. Today our topic is short path problems. Many problems can be modeled using graphs with weights assigned to their edges. As an illustration, consider how an airline system can be modeled. We set up the basic graph model by representing cities by vertices and flights by edges. Problems involving distances can be modeled by assigning distances between cities to the edges. Problems involving flight time can be modeled by assigning flight times to edges. Problems involving fares can be modeled by assigning fares to the edges. Consider, for example, the flight map for Royal Jordanian Airlines. If our problem involves distances, then we can assign distances between cities to the edges. For example, Amman Khartoum, 4,000 km. Amman Cairo, 2,200 km. Amman New Delhi, 6,000 km, etc. If our problem involves flight times, then we can assign flight times to edges. For example, Amman Kuwait, 3 hours, 10 minutes. Amman Rabat, 5 hours, 5 minutes, etc. If our problem involves fares, then we can assign fares to the edges between the cities. For example, Amman, Sana'a, 900 JD. Amman, Baghdad, 300 JD, etc. Now consider the route from Amman to New Delhi. We can go directly or through Abu Dhabi or through Kuwait or Baghdad, Kuwait, New Delhi, etc. There are several ways to reach New Delhi. Now, in addition to this flight map, if we add the flight maps for other companies, then there will be several ways to travel from one city to another. Which route has the minimum cost or the minimum distance or the minimum flight time, etc. There are several different algorithms that find the shortest path between two vertices in a weighted graph. We will present a greedy algorithm developed by the Dutch mathematician Dijkstra in 1959. Dijkstra's algorithm has many variations, but the most common one is to find the shortest path from the source vertex to all other vertices in the graph. So this variation is called single source shortest path algorithm. It's a greedy algorithm. In greedy strategy, problem is solved in stages by taking one step and considering one output at a time to get the optimal solution. The main idea, shortest path vertex selected next. After that, we update the shortest path of other vertices. This process of updating other paths is called relaxation. Any vertex can be selected as a source, and the algorithm can be applied to directed and undirected connected graphs. The algorithm steps are as follows. Mark your selected initial node with a current distance of 0 and the rest with infinity. Set the non-visited node with the smallest current distance as the current node. For each neighbor n, for your current node C, add the current distance of C with the weight to the edge connecting Cn. If it's smaller than the current distance of n, set it as the new current distance of n. After completing the updating or relaxation process, mark the current node C as visited. Continue this process while there are non-visited nodes. I will demonstrate these steps through example. Example, use Dijkstra's algorithm to find the length of the shortest path between the vertices A and F in the following weighted graph. First, we set the distance of the source vertex A with 0 and the distance of others with infinity. After that, we start the updating process or relaxation process for vertex A. A is connected with B, the distance is 5. 0 plus 5, 5. Since 5 is less than infinity, then we update this value to 5. In the same manner, 0 plus 3 to C, 3 less than infinity, we update this value to 3. Next, the unvisited vertices are C, B, D, E, F. The vertex with the smallest distance is the vertex C. We set C as a current node. C is connected to E with distance 8, 3 plus 8, 11, less than infinity. We update this value to 11. 3 plus 6, 9, less than infinity. We update this value to 9. 3 plus 1, 4, the distance here is 5, so we update this value to 4. We are done with C. We mark it as visited. Now we have unvisited B, D, E, F. The vertex with the minimum distance is the vertex B. We mark it as the current node. B is connected to D with distance 4. 4 plus 4, 8, less than 9. We relax this value to 8. B is connected to C, but C is not in the set of vertices. It was visited. We are done with B, so we mark it as visited. Next, the vertices D, E, and F. The vertex with minimum distance is D. D is connected to F, 8 plus 6, 14, less than infinity, so we update this value to 14. To E, 8 plus 2, 10. 10 is less than 11, we update this value to 10. Now we are done with D, we mark it as visited. We have the remaining vertices, E and F. The vertex with the minimum cost is E. E is connected to F, 10 plus 3, 13, less than 14, we update this value to 13. Now we are done with E, we mark it as visited. The only remaining vertex is F, so we are done. Now here we have the distances from A to all other vertices. Here 4, 10, 8, 13. The shortest path from A to B is 4, to C is 3, to D is 8, to E is 10, and to F is 13. The relaxation process is done as follows. If we have the two vertices, U, V, and the distance or cost of the vertex U is CU, and the distance or cost of vertex B is CB. The distance between two vertices is distance UV. We add the distance DUV to the cost U. If this value is greater than the cost of vertex B, CB, then we do not change anything. This means that we could reach the vertex B with this cost. But if CU plus DUV is less than CB, we have to update this value to CU plus DUV, which means that we can reach V through U with less distance or cost. This piece of code can be written as follows. If cost U plus distance UV less than cost V, then we update the cost of V to CU plus DUV. Next, I will repeat the same example, but with the necessary data structures to implement the algorithm. Really, we can implement the algorithm in several ways. One way is to use a set distance map and heap map. We create a set with all the vertices in the graph, A, B, C, D, E, F. In the distance map, we have all the edges with their weights, A, B, 5, A, C, 3, B, C, 1, etc., and the last one, E, F, 3. We create a heap map, size equals to the number of vertices. If we are interested only on the short path from the source A to all other vertices in the graph, we can use only the heap map. But if we are interested in the path as well, we have to create a path map. In the path, we have two vertices, the current vertex and its parent. I will use these data structures without working on the graph. First, we set the distance of A to zero and the distance of other vertices to infinity. A is the start node, the parent of A is null. Now A is set as the current node. A is connected to B. We have AB5, 0 plus 5, 5 less than infinity. We update this value to 5. And we have to fix in the path map that the parent of B now is A. A is connected to C as well. AC3, 0 plus 3, 3 less than infinity. We update this value to 3. And we have to fix in the path map that the parent of C is A. A is not connected to other vertices. We are done with A. We remove it from the set V, mark it as visited. Among the remaining vertices in set V, the vertex with the smallest cost is the vertex C. We set C as the current node. C is connected to A, visited to B with distance 1. 3 plus 1, 4, less than 5. We update this value to 4. And we have to update the parent of B. Now the parent is C. C is connected to D here. The distance is 6. 3 plus 6, 9. We set this value to 9. And we fix the parent of D is C. C is connected to E as well here. CE 8. 3 plus 8, 11, less than infinity. We update this value to 11. And we said that the parent of E is C, the current node. We are done with C. We remove it from B and mark it as visited. Among the remaining vertices, the vertex B has the minimum distance or cost, 4. B is connected to A, visited, to C, visited, next to D, with distance 4. 4 plus 4, 8, less than 9. We update this value to 8. And we have to fix that the parent of D is now B. B is not connected to any other vertices, not visited. So we remove B from B, mark it as visited. Among the remaining vertices, D, E, and F, D has the minimum distance. We set D as the current node. D is connected to B visited, to C visited, to E not visited. D equals 2. 8 plus 2, 10, less than 11. We update this value to 10. And we have to update the parent of E. Now the parent of E is D. D is connected to F. 8 plus 6, here, 14, less than infinity. We update this value to 14. And we have to fix in the path map that the parent of F is D. We are done with D. We remove it from V and we set it as visited. Really, I mark here for demo purposes. We can know that it was visited since it is not now in B. Next, among the remaining vertices in B, E and F, the vertex with minimum distance is E. We mark E as the current node. E is connected to C visited, D visited to F with distance 3. 10 plus 3, 13, less than 14. We update this value to 13. And we have to update the parent of F. Now the parent of F is E. E is not connected to other vertices. We remove it from B, mark it as visited. The only remaining vertex is F, and the edges from F to D and to E were considered. Now we are done. Here we have the shortest distances from A to all other vertices. The shortest distance from A to B4, to C3, to D8, to E10, and to F13. If we want to know the path, for example, from A to F, the shortest distance is 13. the path is if the parent of f is e, here this path, the parent of e is d, here the parent of d is b, the parent of b is c, here, and the parent of c is a, and a is the source. So the minimum distance from a to f is 13, and the path is AC, CB, BD, DE, EF. And the shortest path from A to B is 4, and the path is the parent of B is C, and the parent of C is A, AC, CB, not AB, etc. The complexity of Dijkstra's algorithm is big O n squared. So Dijkstra's algorithm is greedy. It's very efficient algorithm for finding the shortest path from any vertex in the graph to all other vertices. It has the disadvantage that it does not guarantee the optimal solution if the graph has negative weights. There is another algorithm, Bellman-Ford, that can find the shortest path even if the graph has negative weights. Another example of the shortest path problems is the traveling salesman problem. Traveling salesman problem. I have a video about this problem. You can find it in the algorithms design and analysis playlist. For today, that's all. Thank you.